Gotta hand some cash over for safekeeping. I'm in the French. Can you get some supplies over to the French ward?
Going at you. Hang tight.
How can I take off your hands?
Keep this safe.
On my way.
Come.
See anything you need? Let me see what you got. Oh.
If you're happy with that, see you later.
A name for your judge. Cornelius Holden. He just made a call to Lou.
I get worked up. I barely avoided that. It's gonna take Lou. Then I pay me enough. I'm gonna stop you right there, Cornelius. Never know who might be listening in. You need to get this shit under control here. Because until you do, your brother's case isn't going anywhere. There's no call for that kind of talk. I'll send over a car, a couple of my best men.
Cornelius is 60. The dipshits of this state first elected him to the Fifth Circuit in 1951. There's something else you should know. Those two men are Lamont Harris and Trey McCall. They were killed by a man named Hollis Dupree.
Yeah, I heard he gunned them down when they showed up to his house asking for help.
Hollis claims he was in self-defense, said he thought they were there to kill him. Cornelius is the judge that's presiding over the trial.
So killing him might kick up a lot of noise.
Cornelius is an entitled southern asshole. Killing him is going to do a lot more than kick up some noise. Hopefully, it'll send a message that is long past the time that those cocksuckers went extinct. That's the car down there that Lou was talking about.
That thing armored?
I pulled the work order for it. It's a complete custom job. Tough as hell. It'll take a pounding, but it won't be impossible. Cornelius is scheduled to leave any time now, so this is your window.
You follow a set route?
Not since the trial started, but he still makes a stop or two on the way home. So, you can either hit him then, or go after him when he's driving around.
All right.
I hear you.
And watch out for the cops.
Thank you. You want to hear Marcano tear Uncle Lou a new one?
Lou Marcano was bribing a district judge named Cornelius Holden, is that correct?
Sal Marcano spent a lot of money getting Holden in his pocket. A lot of money. Judges like that don't come cheap. And with Holden out of the picture, Sal had to find someone else to legalize gambling.
And that person was State Senator Walter Jacobs.
That's right.
You had one fucking job, Lou. Now it's to keep holding him one goddamn pistol after that room.
What was I supposed to do? He wouldn't listen, Sal. It ain't my fault.
Nothing's ever your goddamn fault. I swear, if you wasn't my brother, I'd clip you myself.
Now listen here. I know a guy, a state senator named Jacobs. He's on the Revenue and Fiscal Affairs Committee. Has a lot of influence.
Can we get to him?
Already have. He has a thing for fucking on women who ain't his wife.
I don't want to twist this guy's balls out of the gate, you understand? We need to be smart about this.
Yeah, of course. How about I throw him a fundraiser on the riverboat? Show him a real nice time. Get him laid, all that shit.
This goddamn casino got me tapped, you understand? This goes down to shit, or we're fucked, all of us.
Well, I'll pick the guests myself. Make sure they know what's what. Then we'll take a nice long cruise down the bayou, get them all liquored up. Once he sees that payday, Jacobs is gonna do whatever we want.
Lou Marcano knew everyone. I mean, politicians, merchants, lawyers, bankers. He insisted on being called Uncle Lou and was basically the Santa Claus of the French ward.
According to the police reports, Mr. Marcano and Mr. Jacobs were killed during a fundraiser on a riverboat.
Thing about the bayou is it's a very big place. You could blow the living shit out of everything in sight and no one would even notice.
Ready to go when you are.
Assume you already mapped out where the riverboat's gonna go.
Lou's pretty fastidious about that kind of thing. Always follows the same path when he goes cruising through the bayou. Doesn't want anything to happen to his beloved Delphine.
Gonna be the least of his problems. You recon the area?
There's an old coal dumper that they have to sail past. I've already got it rigged to blow. You just need to connect the primer cord to each block and then set it off. Detonator's down by your feet.
All right.
Isolate and kill. Lincoln Clay's specialty. What's wrong? It's the boat thing, isn't it?
Not saying it is, not saying it ain't.
You need to get over it. You were on, what, 45 PBRs in country?
52. That's not the point. You don't know what it's like to get onto a boat knowing full well the damn thing's gonna sink. It's old, man.
Look, you blow the coal dumper. Boom. It hits the boat. Then you jump on board and kill Lou and those other assholes. 50-50, you don't even get wet.
50-50?
Well, 40-60, but still. $30.70 at the worst.
about. Let's get you upstairs. You'll fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
taking cover!
Sack of shit down!
That's far enough, you wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Take another step and he gets it.
You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please! Please, I don't even know what's going on!
Money? You can have it. All of it. Just don't kill me.
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yeah. Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
Jacobs was killed this evening in a fiery explosion aboard a riverboat. Local businessman Louis Marcano also lost his life, along with dozens of other wealthy donors there to attend a political fundraiser.
When Lincoln left his gutted body on a statue commemorating Andrew Jackson, people were horrified. I mean, how could that be anything but a political statement?
Yeah. Goddamn motherfucking piece of shit! Lou's dead. They found him tied to that statue of Andrew Jackson over in the French ward. He was gutted like a goddamn catfish.
Jesus Christ, Pops.
This was that goddamn nigger, Lincoln Clay. We wouldn't be in this fucking mess if you'd done what you were supposed to do.
You were there. I shot him right in the head.
Once! You shot him once! Son of a bitch! Oh, this is just what I fucking need. Holden's dead. Jacob's dead. Christ, without them, this casino isn't going anywhere. Unless I can figure something out.
What about the governor?
What about him?
Wasn't he into us a while back?
What, for them hookers? Yeah, but he paid all that off.
But I still got the pictures.
It's gonna take more than pictures of him humping on some broad to swing him around on our side. You understand? A lot more.
Always call Leo Galante.
No. Fuck him. The whole reason I'm building this goddamn casino is to get out from under them worthless fucks. I bring in the commission, they're gonna wanna cut everything. God damn it. Go on, get the hell out of here. I gotta make a call. Leo! Yeah, Sal! How the fuck are you? Yeah, listen, I got something I need to discuss.
I
tried to reconcile the part of me that helped Lincoln with the part of me that vowed to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ. But I can't. You know what I remember? I remember watching the news and learning they had gunned down Dr. King. I remember watching people lash out, riot, because that's all they had left. All the while, Lincoln's in the other room, barely clinging to life. Maybe that's why I did what I did.
Come on, let's go.
Come morning, this city's gonna learn that their dear old Uncle Lou didn't die out there in the swamps when his riverboat sank. And with Lou dead, Sal's gonna be scrambling to figure out his next move. Meanwhile, we're gonna take control of the plowhouse, the cistern, and all the drinking and fucking in the French ward.
Time for me to run something more than a holler, brother. You got us secure in the district? I see no reason we shouldn't remain there.
To say I'm biding my time would be a fucking understatement. I got no idea where your mind's at, but my patience is running short.
Come on, you know me. You got me running most of the fucking city. And hell, man, doing what I'm doing here for you is in my fucking blood. And I'll spill any amount of that blood to defend it.
You know I'm the only one who will really have your back.
I get it. You gotta consider all your options.
The two of us, we're not escaping each.
Gotta say, this action's perfect for Cassandra.
How about you quit wasting my goddamn time? No one here's got more know-how than yours truly. If you can't see that, then you can go fuck yourself.
Sit down, Burke. You're just embarrassing yourself.
Better luck next time, I guess.
We'll talk later. Get on out of here.